Hey ladies and gentlemen, Steven here from Rattle Essence and welcome back to another video. Thank you so much for joining me today. Here we have it, Gucci Bloom Profumo di Fiori, a brand new release from the company Gucci for 2020. I'm excited to tell you all about it, so make sure to stay tuned. Now, before I give you my review of Gucci Bloom Profumo di Fiori, I just want to say that if you are a fan of perfume reviews, pretty much any fragrance-related content, please do consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. All you have to do is click on that red button in the corner. And of course, while you're at it, make sure to enable notifications by clicking on that bell icon. So whenever I do release these fragrance reviews and top lists, they will get delivered straight to your feed. You never need to worry about missing any of my future content. So Gucci Bloom Profumo di Fiori, if you are a fan of Gucci Bloom, the original that came out a few years ago, I think chances are you are going to fall in love with this one. However, there are some notable differences between this one and the original. I mean, the perfumer is Alberto Morias, that has remained the same. The creative director is Alessandro Michele. But when I first took a look at this bottle, the color of the bottle, but also the note breakdown, I noticed that in addition to the bottle being yellow, as opposed to the original, which is pink, there are also solar notes in the note breakdown, which is an accord, obviously. And when you think of solar notes, what do you think of necessarily? Do you think of citrus? Do you think of aldehydes? Do you think of yellow flowers like freesia or ylang ylang? And there is actually ylang ylang in this fragrance. And so it kind of all synced up for me when I smelled it for the first time. And there's also something about this that I'm going to tell you a little bit later on in the review. There is something about Gucci Bloom Profumo di Fiori that my wife fell in love with, and it is definitely going to be one of the fragrances she's going to be wearing the most over the next few months. I'm excited to tell you more about the smell. Let's start with the presentation. So the box for this fragrance is very similar to the original. It has this floral print and floral motif all over it. Your serial number is punched into the bottom of the box on top of the UPC, and all of your ingredients are located on the back. And the bottle for this one is very similar to the original, with the exception that this one is yellow as opposed to the original, which is pink. Your serial number is printed on the bottom of the bottle on top of a sticker in white ink. And the cap for this fragrance has Gucci engraved into it. Now the cap does click into place very securely. You can pick this one up from the cap. And the distribution on the atomizer is nice and wide. So in the opening of this fragrance, you are going to get this beautiful jasmine note. There is sandbach jasmine included in this fragrance. And when it comes to jasmine, there are a few elements, especially when it's done on a designer level, because jasmine is actually very expensive. And so what perfumers typically rely on is a combination of jasminol, which is the molecule that makes it smell floral. They rely on a molecule called cis-3-hexanol, which makes it smell a little bit earthy and grassy. And they also rely on a molecule called indole. Indole is a naturally occurring element that is found in jasmine, and it also makes it smell a little musky and a little animalic. What I get from this fragrance is a combination of all three of those elements, and I think that that contributes to the natural and organic smell that I get from Gucci Bloom Profumo di Fiori. Now, of course, when you take a look at the original Gucci Bloom, yes, that contains jasmine as well. And I think it's that note that unifies the two fragrances. But in this one, you have a couple other notes that I think are pretty interesting. You have a note called Rangoon Creeper, and that note is also known as Chinese honeysuckle. And so when I think of honeysuckle, I think of a floral note that kind of smells like white florals, that has fruity accents, and it started to make sense for me. But there's also ylang ylang. And ylang ylang can kind of give off this sort of fruity banana-like vibe. And I see how both of those florals contribute to that fruity overtone that is also found in this fragrance. Now, don't get me wrong, I do find that Gucci Bloom Profumo di Fiori is mostly a floral fragrance. And I can see it being one that is very comfortably worn in the summer months. And I think the reason why my wife kind of gravitated more towards this one is because she likes that component about it that smells a little like suntan lotion. I know that's gonna sound really, really weird, but there's a certain creaminess about it, even a little lactonic, if you will. And I think it's that association with coconut or these sort of summery floral type fragrances that she fell in love with. And I love the smell of this fragrance. I think it's so natural. You have this bouquet of florals in the opening. There's a little bit of a sweetness to it as well. I know sandalwood is listed as a note, and sandalwood has a a reputation of being a little bit smooth and sweet as well, as opposed to other woodsy ingredients. But I think it's really the marriage of all the florals in here that makes this one such an addictive fragrance, and one that is very comfortably worn in the summer months. Now, in terms of the occasions and stuff like that, I do find this one has a bit more of a casual vibe. And of course, when you tie it into the narrative of the fragrance, which I really try not to pay too much attention to, when you think of Gucci Bloom Profumo di Fiori, you think of a fragrance that is appropriate for casual scenarios, a really nice sundress, you're just letting your hair out, you just want to go through your day not feeling overly tied to anything, if you will. You just want to feel very casual, very relaxed, very laid back, nonchalant. You don't want to feel too uptight or anything like that. And I just think that it's a very carefree composition. That's the word that I was looking for. It's a very carefree composition, and I think that's the element about it that I like the most. But there's this sort of feminine quality about it that I am really overwhelmed in a positive way about. And I feel like there's nothing about this fragrance that is difficult to wear or difficult to pull off. I think it's a very accessible formula. It's a very accessible composition. And there's nothing delicate about it either. You know, I think that some floral fragrances out there have this sort of fragile, for lack of a better word, quality about it, where it's very wispy, it's very airy, it's very soft. This one, you can tell, has a weightiness underneath everything else. You can tell it's very well grounded because of the woodsy elements in the base and, you know, some of these fruity accents, that it's not this overdose of, you know, citrus and aldehydes that is being relied upon to give it this solar accord in the opening. There's so much more to it than that. And I love this one. I think this is one of the best releases of 2020 on the women's side. And I own Marc Jacobs Perfect. I own Black Orchid Parfum. I own Rose and Roses by Miss Dior. I own many fragrances that were released for women in 2020. And every single time my wife has worn this one, which we've had now for 5 days or something like that, I have been loving it. And this has kind of become her new signature scent, and I hope she continues to wear it well into the autumn because it smells fantastic. Let's go ahead and finish things off with my overall assessment. Now, first up, in terms of the uniqueness and the overall smell, I must say it's not the most unique fragrance in the sense that, okay, it kind of smells like the original Gucci Bloom, but Gucci Bloom Profumo di Fiori is a nice and a healthy enough deviation from the original that I think if you are a fan of the Bloom lineup, you are really going to enjoy this one. And I'm personally very keen on this one. I do enjoy this one quite a bit. And so the overall smell, incredibly pleasant. There's nothing about it that is overwhelming or offensive or anything like that. I just think it's an incredible jasmine fragrance with touches of ylang ylang, a creamy aspect about it, a nice sort of smooth, silky, woodsy warmth underneath everything. And it has this really warm nature about it. It's just an amazing fragrance. Definitely get your nose on it if you are a lady and you're looking for a new fragrance. In terms of the longevity, you're going to get about 7 to 8 hours on your skin. The projection on this one radiates within beyond an arm's length, excuse me, for about 2 to 2.5 hours. And it really wasn't until about that 6 hour mark where it started to sit closer to the skin and it became more of a close encounter scent. In terms of the versatility, I can see this one being worn formally as well as casually. However, I do think that given the name and given the narrative and given the notes, it kind of comes across a little bit more casual. But if you want to wear this one dressed up and, you know, in a formal scenario, I think you can pull it off there as well. I think that the summer month is really when this one is going to shine just because of the inclusion of many of the notes. For the winter months, I would probably go for something that's a little bit more woodsy leaning, something that's a little bit sweeter, something that has more oriental touches to it. But this one, I can see it being worn in the spring, summer, and fall. I just think in the winter, I'd be likely to go with something else. And I think this one is appropriate for women of any age. And I do think that it leans a little bit more feminine as opposed to masculine. In terms of the presentation, I love it. I love the motif of the flowers here on the box, which is also found on the original and I love the color of the bottle, very bright and exuberant, and it really pops. My final verdict on this fragrance is I think this is a beautiful jasmine fragrance that can be had at the designer level. And I think under the creative direction of Alessandro Michele and the talented perfumer Alberto Morias, this is a fantastic fragrance that I would highly urge you to check out the next time you are in Macy's, which is where I purchased this one. And I think it's a wonderful fragrance. So thank you so much for tuning in. That was my review of Gucci Bloom Profumo di Fiori. If you have any experience with this fragrance or any of the other Gucci Bloom fragrances, please go ahead and let me know what you think. Leave a comment down below. I always love the interaction. And also, please don't forget to subscribe for future videos. And of course, that includes fragrance reviews just like this, but also top 10 videos, giveaways, unboxings, special guests, interviews, and a whole lot more. Thanks again for watching. I love you all. We'll see you next time.